Hello and welcome to Let's Read the Books of Daggerfall. I'm Amethyst Lunatari. Today I'll be reading Fool's Ebony, Part the Twoth, which I bought right here in the Daggerfall Best Pawnbrokers in the city of Daggerfall. Fool's Ebony, Part the Twoth, Dramatis Personae. Prologue, The Adventurer. A dark elf, Rascal Koman, a priest of Akatosh, Leban, another priest of Akatosh. Epilogue, Steet, a priest of Julianos Raik, another priest of Julianos, Shub, a mage, Shub, a different mage of the same name, Nephron, a somewhat sleazy merchant, five armorers, Ortho Kryn, husband of Millie, a lusty Contessa Millie, innkeep and philosopher Guernsey, bovine wench, assorted wenchins, and cads of the tavern, soldiers, dwarves, giants. Part the Twoth, bearing mostly on Fool's Ebony and temples. Same place, same inn, a bottle or two later. Enter Prologue, The Adventurer, and Leban. Prologue, little has occurred so far in our comedic drama. The adventurer, our dark elf rascal, has brought drinks for two priests of Akatosh. All have drunk considerably. One of the priests has rushed off in pursuit of his lamp girl. And unless I've forgotten something, or something happened when I was paying attention to something else, that's a complete synopsis of Part the Oneth. Ah, here come two more priests. Humble prologue must depart. Enter Raik and Steet. Raik. Evening, Leban. Evening, stranger. My fellow priest here is Steet. I am Raik. We are honored to serve Julianos. Adventurer. What is this anyway? Priest night out? And I thought that your temples, Akatos, Julianos, the rest, I thought them all cutthroat competitors. In theology and gold, if you will forgive my bluntness. Yet you all seem the best of friends. Come to think of it, didn't I have words with Steet earlier? You said you were of the temple of Stendar? Raik. A common misconception, friend. Leban. But one that we encourage. Raik. Really, we all work together closely, move between the temples as needs dictate. Leban. Exchange information. Raik. Share funds. Steet. Swap our sisters. Leban kicks Steet. Enter prologue. Prologue. Sorry to interrupt the merry slapstick, but I neglected to mention earlier that the Fool's Gold Saga, if that is the word, contains gratuitous reference to priestly misdeeds and sexual excess. I hope that those of you in the audience of peevish, prudish, sullen, frumpy, or grumpy demeanors are not offended. Now then, on with the entertainment. Exit prologue. Leban. And all that. Raik. But it helps in our holy work if we are perceived as separate and, competitive. Leban. Mind you, there are one or two, religious organizations, well, sort of, that we do not have anything to do with. Raik. Nothing at all, nothing at all. Animals, just animals. Adventurer. Such as? Leban. Well, the Dark Brotherhood for one nasty bunch of thugs, and then there's the After Dark Society. Aside to Raik. This fellow seems a decent sort of chap, seems to know something about mages and Fool's Ebony. Raik, aside to Leban. Really now? How interesting. To all. Hey, fellow, have another bottle. This will bless you throat. My, yes, indeed it will. Adventurer. Thanks, Raik. Don't mind a bit. Leban. But let me continue. I was explaining about this Fool's Ebony to you. Raik. Yes, Fool's Ebony. Leban. Well, Fool's Ebony now. Well, you know about ordinary ebony, how it's rare. Only some dwarven clans dig it and sell it, and not too many these days and times. Steet, how's that popular song go? Singing, where have all the old dwarves gone? Long time ago. Leban throws innkeep at Steet. Raik breaks chair on innkeep and Steet. Innkeep loses consciousness. Leban, there's a pile of real ebony up in the Rothgarian Mountains somewhere north, I hear tell. You know how that dullish black ebony gets worked over by mages, by some skilled armorers, made into all kinds of potent weapons, amulets, belts, what have you. all fetch a huge price, when you can find any, and how the best was made long ago by those old dwarves. Steet raises to his feet. Levin kicks Steet back down. The adventurer loosens his tunic. Levin, oh my! Oh my apologies, friend sir! See, you have... what's that? An ebony torque? Oh my! And an ebony katana! Oh my! Oh my my! So of course you know all that, sir. Adventurer, oh that's right, you didn't know. Here, have another bottle. Levin, many thanks, kind sir. Well, then you know how every adventurer, even snotty kids, all the dungeon delvers, are always looking for ebony artifacts, weapons, whatnot. But what you may not know, some of the more experienced delvers hunt for raw ebony loads, piles, dwarven leavings. That stuff, the raw ebony, is far more valuable. Adventurer, the raw, unshaped material that provides work and power for so few? Apparently just loaded with negative magicka? Rayek, right, right. Levin, yes, quite so, quite so. Well, fool's ebony now. Looks like just about the real raw stuff. Runs in veins in the deep rocks. Feels the same, smells almost the same. But the big difference, it's not real ebony. No power at all. If you pick some up, it gets your hands a bit dirty. Softer too, by all accounts, but sort of shiny too. But who can tell all that? Deep in some mine, maybe a ghoul breathing down your neck. So it's just grab and run, I guess, down in those nasty holes. So the fools, the kids, the crazy delvers are always hauling up a bag, a sack of fool's ebony and getting laughed at by the merchants. Dealers, mages, us. Hence the fool's part. Stuff just gets thrown into the bay. Adventurer. Yeah, that's sort of what I heard from some mages, but I heard something else, too. Levin. And just what was that, friend, if you want to tell us, of course, sir? Adventurer. Oh, of course. I think we can come to an arrangement. Levin and Rayek, together. Certainly. Oh, yes. Adventurer. So, yeah, so these mages, Shub and Shub, they always called Shub, aren't they? Anyway, these old guys were saying how this fool's ebony can burn. Not magically, but like an ordinary piece of wood. But the flame lasts far longer, gives off lots more heat, makes no smoke to speak of, no noise. Very interesting. Mages were saying as how the alchemists want it to heat the retorts and flasks, how the Mages Guild wants it to make and sell fake amulets and the like. Rotten trick, that. And especially the armorers, they want it bad, for their forges, I guess, and the alchemists for their alembics. Levin, precisely my information. Now, gets cold up here in the winter, doesn't it? And everyone is cutting down all those trees, making siege engines, boats, all that evil war machinery. All those rich royals and merchants got to heat their great big piles of homes, so their countesses can run around in next to nothing instead of furs. Steet, just like my sister. Levin bites Steet's arm. Steet shrieks and falls unconscious. Adventurer, all those armorers gotta keep their hearths and furnaces running. Levin, all the mages gotta keep their familiars warm. Rayek, all those royals gotta keep the contessas running. Levin, all those peasants gotta keep their animals warm. Adventurer, and to Sheogorath with his wife and kids, right? Huh, and I guess it's sort of hard for you priests to give blessings and cures when your fingers are all cold and stiff. Makes getting corks out a tad hard, to say nothing of those little twists of parchment. Rayek, you speak truly indeed. Levin, a man of wisdom indeed, yes. Adventurer, so where do we find this fool's ebony in quantity? Levin, you put your finger, you have six, I know, oh, excuse me, sir, on the crux of the matter. I have heard rumors, just rumors, mind you, that there are huge, enormous veins of this stuff at one place on the surface, far off, far up in the Rothgarians. Bad, bad place to go. But if you can get there and back, cartloads of the stuff. Adventurer, that's just what I overheard from those mages. Far up there in the Rothgarians. Orcs, dragonlings, Daedra, Sheogorath, only knows what. Those mages seem to know the spot, though. Mages wanted someone to... Rick, you didn't talk to the mages. I mean, you haven't... Adventurer. Oh, no, they didn't even know I was there. Aside. Not yet, anyway. Levin. Good, good. Can't trust those mages, you know. Old fossils would turn their own mothers into sludge toads just for a bit of gold. Gold mad, power mad, mad mad. The whole rotten lot of them. But they don't have mothers. Rayek. Excellent. Seems to me, friend, or can we call you partner? Yes, excellent. Seems to me, partner, that my brother priests and you should do some digging and poking around, see if we can get to those veins, those deposits, huh? Adventurer. Yes, indeed, partners, but it would cost a fair pile of gold to get up there. Weapons, spells, women, clothing, carts, and horses, women, food, potions. Best go well prepared up there. Lemon. No problem, partner. Our temples have certain resources, such that if we were guaranteed sole access, sole knowledge of the location, then we could finance someone, someone with the requisite skills such as yourself. Just by happenstance, I am keeper of the books. You see the opportunity? Adventurer. Oh yes, oh yes. Well, let's split a last bottle and shake on an agreement. Levin. Indeed, let us. We first need information, who knows about the site up there, where it is, how to reach it. Why don't we meet back here in, say, a week to the hour, and see what we can learn, meanwhile? Rayek. We need to find a merchant, too, someone who can handle it for us. Warehouses, distribution. Levin. And keep a shut mouth. Adventurer. I'll make some inquiries about merchants. Got a contact or two. Trouble is, well, you know how these things go. Few golds here, few there. Before you know it, you've bribed half the town, or so it seems. Now, as luck would have it, I don't have much. Got swindled by a wretched mage some town south of here, and lost most of my belongings in a shipwreck. Levin. Ah, yes, you need some seed money, as it were. Rayek to Levin. Let me lift old Steet's purse. He made a lot renting out his sister last week. Levin. Thank you, Rayek. Here, about 100 gold. Enough? Adventurer. Oh, yes, more than enough for a start. Gentlemen. Good, good, good. So we have a deal? Adventurer. Yes. It's agreed. 1 week. Exit Levin, Rayek dragging Steet. Exit the adventurer. Enter epilogue. Epilogue. Ah, things are happening now. I doubt it not. Patrons, I request that you recall that this is a work of fiction created by one of the finest writers of the asylum, Friendships, Archprince of all Somerset. There is no such thing as Fool's Ebony. Furthermore, Ebony is not mined as the priests have described in the process. Grasp that, please. If you can still enjoy the play as a rude work of fiction, stay with us for part the 30th. If you can't, farewell, and don't forget to tip the wenches. And so endeth part the 2th. Thank you for listening to Let's Read the Books of Daggerfall, Fool's Ebony, part the 2th.